Hello everyone, my name is Iris France, and today we're going to continue to talk about supply, in particular, supply shifters, meaning what would change our supply. When there is an increasing supply, we know that the supply curve is going to shift to the right. And when there is a decreasing supply, we know that the supply curve is going to shift to the left. So what would increase or decrease our supply? That depends on many factors, and we'll talk about them one by one. So the first one is resource price. Now continue with our example of cappuccino in Francetown. So we know cappuccino, you need to use coffee beans and you need to use milk to make it. Now suppose the price of milk goes up, then it becomes more costly to make cappuccino. Therefore, that will decrease our supply of cappuccino and shifting the supply of cappuccino to the left. And by contrast, if there is a decrease in resource price or decrease in the price of milk, then that's going to make it cheaper to make cappuccino, which will increase our supply of cappuccino, shifting our supply curve from S1 to S2, shifting to the right. So the first one is resource price. And the second factor is technology. So technology make it cheaper to produce cappuccino. So suppose there's a new technology, new kind of a coffee machine that will make cappuccino a lot faster, a lot more efficient, then that will make it less costly to produce cappuccino, shifting our supply curve of cappuccino to the right. So technology will also change our supply, in particular, increase our supply. And the third one is number of sellers. So suppose there are a lot of immigrants coming to Francetown and they all decide they're going to sell cappuccino, then that's going to shift our supply curve to the right. And by contrast, if people are leaving Francetown, in particular, if there are fewer sellers of cappuccino, that will shift our supply curve to the left. And the fourth one is producer expectations of future price. So think about this, if you expect the price to go down later and you're a seller of a certain good, then you want to quickly dump it before the price goes down. So you want to sell it before the price goes down. So if you expect the price to go down, then your supply is going to go up now. And by contrast, if you expect the price to go up later, then you kind of want to hoard it and wait until the price goes up, then you will sell it, right? So if you expect the price to go up later, then your supply is going to go down now because you want to hoard it and wait until the price goes up, then you're going to sell it. So this concludes the factors of demand shifters. And thanks for watching. Good luck with your studying.